After watching this video, you can make your R36S perfect. I wanted to make this video as useful as possible, so I tried to combine all the essential information for those who just bought the R36S and want to set it up for stable performance. I won't drag this out with a long intro, let's get straight to it. By the way, this video is also suitable for owners of the R36XX, R36H, R35S, and even the PowKiddy RGB20S. So after you buy the R36S, make sure to verify that your console is original using this page, because lately there have been more and more clones being sold as genuine devices. Pay close attention to the key indicators, the X button, the main menu, and so on. If you accidentally bought a fake, I recommend returning it to the seller for a refund and then reordering the console from one of the verified stores. If you want the most reliable version, go for the R36XX. It's basically the same console as the R36S, but with built-in Wi-Fi. Aside from that, they're identical. Just a small tip to help you avoid any unpleasant surprises. Let's move on to the next step. I always recommended replacing the default SD cards with branded ones as soon as you buy a console, because default SD cards are low quality and can fail at any moment. Personally, I prefer using two SD cards, one for the firmware and another for storing and running my game collection. When you buy the R36S, especially from AliExpress, you usually have to choose an SD card with the game collection, either 64 GB or 128 GB. But the package typically includes a separate 32 GB SD card with the ArkOS firmware. That means you get two SD cards, one with the firmware and another with games. However, some stores sell the console with only one SD card that contains both the firmware and the games. That's totally fine, and you don't need to worry about it. Either way, you're getting low-quality SD cards, and I highly recommend replacing them with branded ones. I've shown this compatibility table multiple times in my videos, and you'll find a link to it in the description box. It lists SD cards that work well with the R36S. You can use either one or two SD cards. Personally, I prefer to separate the system from the games, so I always use two. Once you're sure your console is original, let's reinstall the firmware. You can't just copy it from the SD card, it needs to be installed from scratch. First, we need to find out which screen version is installed on your console. To do that, I remove the default SD card with the stock firmware and plug it into my computer. Then I go to a special website that helps identify your screen version. You'll find the link to this site in the description box. Make sure to read the instructions carefully. You'll need to upload a file with one of these names. On the SD card, in the boot section, I choose this specific file and then click the Identify my screen button. As you can see, I have the original screen. In your case, it might say Panel 4 or something else entirely. Important note, if you don't see these files in the boot section or if the boot partition is missing altogether, chances are you have a clone. If you see this message, it most likely means you uploaded the wrong file or your console has a Panel 4 screen. Sometimes newer consoles with Panel 4 can show this message. Just continue with the installation for the Panel 4 screen. So once you know which screen version you have, it's time to download the ArkOS firmware. Choose whichever download source is easiest for you. Next, we need to install the firmware onto a new high-quality SD card. I've already shown how to flash the firmware in previous videos, whether you're using a Mac, Windows, or even an Android device. You'll find separate videos for each platform in the description box. The process is pretty simple, no matter which OS or device you're using. First, unzip the archive we just downloaded, then use a flashing tool to write the image onto your new SD card. I usually use Etcher app on both Mac and Windows, it's free and super easy to use. But if you're not very tech savvy or this is your first time doing it, make sure to follow one of my step-by-step videos. Once flashing is done, I eject the SD card from my Mac and insert it into the first slot on the console, the one for the operating system. I leave the second slot for game storage empty for now. Now here's the new part. Based on the new ArkOS instructions, right after powering on the console, I need to hold R1 and A buttons. That's the combo for the original screen. In your case, it might be a different combo, like one of the D-pad directions, left, right, up or down. I hold the combo until the console shuts down. Then I turn the console on again. And we see the ArkOS splash screen and the setup process starts. Once the setup is complete and you're on the main screen, go to Options, then to Device Type and choose your console. In my case, it's R35S or R36S. This same option works for the R36XX, while the lower option is for R36H or O30S models. That makes sure the system applies the correct control layout for your device. Confirm by pressing A. That's it, all the main settings are now in place, and the console is ready to go. And before we continue, please take a moment to like this video, subscribe to the channel and leave a comment. It's super important for promoting both the video and the channel. The more likes, views and subscribers we get, the more videos I'll be able to make and share with you, and the more fun and interesting the content will become. Also, don't forget to click the bell icon, so you won't miss any new videos. And if you want to support the channel even more, you can hit the high button. It helps push the video to new audiences and brings even more people into our community. Thanks a ton for your support, let's continue! Now let's move to the next step. We need to transfer the games from the default SD card, which, as we know, is usually very low quality, to a new branded SD card. Insert the new SD card into your computer. It must be empty, so if it's not, format it to exFAT. Then insert the default SD card with the game collection. You'll most likely see a partition called EasyROMs. Open it and copy everything to the new SD card, all folders and all files inside them. This will take a while, since you'll be copying 64 or 128 GB. By the way, you can first copy everything to your computer, so you have an extra backup of the entire game collection. Now, eject the microSD card from your computer and insert it into the console. Then power on or reboot the console. Next, go to the Options section, then Advanced, and at the bottom, select Switch to SD2 for ROMs. This way, the console will prepare the new microSD card, but if the preparation process doesn't start and the menu immediately appears, it means your microSD card is not compatible with the console. In that case, I suggest looking for another microSD card. Now your console has all the game sections installed, but we're not stopping yet. Let's take a closer look at the options panel, so you can understand even more about what your console can do. First, 351 files. It's basically a file manager for simple file operations. I never use it, I prefer doing all file work on my MacBook. The next item is change LED to red. This lets you change the power indicator light to red. And selecting it again switches it back to blue. Another handy option is the time settings. Here you can adjust the time and date. I rarely touch it, but if accurate time matters to you, set it here. There is also File Manager, a classic two-pane file manager that makes copying files easier. Network info is next. It shows useful details when you're connecting to Wi-Fi with an adapter or on the R36XX, which has Wi-Fi built in. Another important one is remove files with underscores. When you copy games to your SD card, you might see stray files with names starting with an underscore. They clutter your game list and get in the way. This menu item deletes them all at once. I use it pretty often. The next option lets you set a static boot image instead of a GIF when you launch a game. Select it again to switch back to the default GIF. I also made a video showing how to set a custom boot GIF, and you can download my GIF from my Telegram channel. The link's in the description box. Subscribe there for more tips and extras. Another option lets you replace the launch image with a short video when a game starts.
Who wants to play video games?
So you can customize the console however you like. Update is one of the key items. When connecting to Wi-Fi, you can update ArkOS to improve performance, add features, and fix bugs. I recommend reading community feedback before updating to avoid potential issues. The Wi-Fi menu lets you connect to your network, and Wi-Fi toggle lets you disable the Wi-Fi module if you rarely use it. That's especially useful to the R36XX to save battery. Now let's go into the advanced section. First is backup ArkOS settings. This is great once your console is fully set up. The backup file is saved on your SD card under Easy ROMs in the backup folder. Clear Last Played Collection lets you wipe the recent games list, handy if you've been testing or if you're setting the console up as a gift. Controller Tester checks whether all the buttons, sticks, and the D-pad are working correctly. Use it if you suspect a button isn't responding. Next is one of my favorite settings – Enable Quick Mode. If you haven't turned this on yet, it will change how you use the console. It automatically saves your game when you exit using the Function plus Start shortcut. And when you launch the game again, it resumes exactly where you left off. It's incredibly convenient, definitely give it a try. The next few options let you reset controller or emulator settings back to default if something stops working or if you accidentally remapped buttons, which happens a lot with PSP games. Resetting the PPSSPP settings can really help. The last menu item will be familiar to many of you. It lets you switch the system to read games from a second SD card, if, like me, you prefer to keep your collection separate. As you can see, the console reads the card, and all the games show up on the main screen. You can always switch back to the primary SD card in the same menu. People often ask how to store games on the main SD card alongside the firmware. It's easy. Copy your game collection, like the one that came with the console, to the SD card that has ArkOS installed inside the EasyRAMs partition. You'll already find directories for every retro systems. You can copy the entire collection or just the games you want, just like I showed in my video about using a second SD card with the R36S. Do it however you prefer. Now that we've explored the console's features, let's move on to the final part of the video and set the optimal settings for PSP games. It's possible that the default settings are already optimal, but it won't hurt to double-check that everything is correct. First, let's start any game from the PSP section. Now, let's go to the emulator settings. If you're using the R36S console on ArkOS, press right analog stick. Go to the settings section and press the B button. On the right side of the screen, you'll see the graphics settings. In the first section, rendering mode, make sure to set rendering resolution to 1x PSP. Check the box next to full screen. Next is the frame rate control section. Set frame skipping to 2. Also, check the box for auto frame skip. Make sure to turn off both alternative speed options. Now, go to the speed hacks section. Turn off everything except the last options. Check the box for lazy texture caching and set spline to low. Next, in the performance section, set buffer graphics commands to up to 2. Be sure to check the boxes for hardware transform and software skinning. In the texture scaling section, set upscale type to hybrid plus bicubic. Turn off both upscale level and deposterize. In the texture filtering section, set it to auto and turn off all other options. In the last section, I turn on the FPS counter to show the frame rate while playing, but you don't have to enable this if you don't want to. After this, go to the left menu and return to the main menu. You can now access the settings and continue playing. The new settings will be saved automatically. If you want a closer look at the settings, feel free to check out and subscribe to my Telegram channel, where I've posted screenshots of these emulator settings. These are the main basic steps you should take right after purchasing the console. But don't stop here, your console can do much more than you think. On my channel, you'll find many videos about setting up the device. First, you can watch the video where I briefly talk about the main settings menu that opens when you press the Start button. This is also where you can change the theme, for example, to the one I'm using. If you like my theme, you can buy it using the link in the description to support my channel. You can also change the theme. I explained how to do that in this video. You can also expand your game collection by adding the Portmaster section. There are tons of free games available there, and you can also play masterpieces like Half-Life 1 and 2, GTA 3 and Vice City, but keep in mind that these titles are not free. You need to own the original PC versions of these games to play them on the console. All video guides are linked in the description box. Recently, I also made a video guide on how to add to Java games on the console. This is another great way to enjoy your favorite titles. And the final guide is for true geeks who want to install an Android-based firmware on the console, or even set up a multi-boot system with both Android and ArkOS. Links to these tutorials are also in the description box. To make things easier, I created a dedicated playlist with all my R36S videos. This will help you find everything you need and customize your console exactly the way you want. I hope I managed to make a complete and helpful video about the basic R36S setup, so please like and subscribe to the channel. I wish you pleasant nostalgia and successful completion of your favorite games.